Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop.
Today's episode has been sponsored in part by Lee Valley. For more information, visit their website at leevalley.com.
Hey everybody, welcome to Matt's Basement Workshop podcast. So, we're going to do something a little bit different than we've ever done here on the show. In the past 4 years, we have never really done any type of Christmas gift discussion, any type of holiday discussion about possible items for the woodworker on your list, probably yourself. But you know what? I was thinking about it the other day. The great folks over at Lee Valley and Veritas have been a fantastic, kind of a quiet sponsor here on the show. They've been doing a little advertising on the website, and in exchange for the advertising, they've given me an opportunity to pick up some of these great tools and bring them here on the show and talk about them and use them in my shop on a daily basis. And so I thought I would share with you a lot of the tools that I've been using. Now, many of these haven't just been picked up in this past year, although several of them on this table have. A lot of them were previous Christmas gifts here in the Vanderlust household. In fact, to be honest with you, for the longest time, the Lee Valley catalog was kind of like the wish book. As soon as it showed up, man, I was going through it, marking everything, you know, dog earring pages and everything, so that my family would know exactly what I wanted. So we got quite a bit of stuff to cover here. Let's go ahead and jump right in with one of my favorite ones. And this is something I've always mentioned to many of you, because sharpening is a real issue when it comes to hand tools. And I think Lee Valley has one of the best sharpening systems out there, and it's the MK2 system. Now, the base unit, when you first get it, is more or less this housing right here. And then, of course, you have what essentially is the angle finder itself. And they fit on together this way, and then you just simply put your blade in and you clamp it down to position. Now, one thing that I really like about this system is, number one, I like the overall width of it. It really holds the blades in the right position and at the right angle. And even if it's a narrow blade, I still feel like I get a lot of control in it. I'm not doing a lot of wiggling when it comes down to it. Now, the base unit comes with a square roller, but you can get an optional one that which is a cambered roller, and so that way you can put a slight camber onto your blades if you're interested at all. The neat thing about it is you can find that with the MK2, you can do all sorts of neat things with it. You can work with higher angle blades, you can work with standard angle blades, and then you can even work with what's called a back bevel. Now, we've never really talked too much about back bevels in here, but maybe in the new year we will do that for sure. So the MK2, like I said, is one of those things that I definitely recommend to everybody, because I think it's a really great way to get you into sharpening without breaking the bank, and on top of it, without all the frustration. Now, along with the MK2, you can also buy a couple other accessories. Like I said, you can get the cambered roller, and then they also have a really great accessory for using with skew blades. Now, we've been using the skew rabbit plane here in the shop, and if I didn't have this particular little gadget here, I'd probably be ripping my hair out trying to find the exact angle to fit in here, because rather than putting the angle finder on the front here that you normally would, you end up putting this one, you just slide it right onto the front, and then you can find the right skew angle, and then you can sharpen it the right way so that you get it correct every single time. So that's a huge accessory that I absolutely love. And it works great with skew chisels also. Now, another item that Lee Valley has is they have this great little small blade sharpener. And the neat thing about this is, if you have ever tried to sharpen like a low angle spoke shave or even some of the other spoke shaves, you know it's really difficult, even with a different, with the pinch kind of sharpening system. But with the MK2, you know, sometimes the hardest part about doing it is finding the right angle. So by having a small blade holder that you can just put in here, in fact, it fits right in like you would a blade. The neat thing about that is that you can get the angle for the small blade, and it just fits right in here. And in fact, I'm not going to worry about it right now, because I want to move on to some of these other things. But you get really great results. So the MK2 is definitely high on the Christmas list. I always, always recommend it. Now, let's see, where can we go to next? Another big tool that I always recommend to people, and it's not really that big, and this is another one of those, whether you use hand tools or power tools, I always recommend getting a really good block plane. Now, this happens to be the Veritas low angle block plane, and I love it for all sorts of reasons. It has an adjustable mouth. The blade is just fantastic. The cap here is nice and solid and wide, and it holds the blade so it doesn't shatter. The movements on this just work fantastic. Now, it's a little bit heavier and a little bit wider than a traditional low angle block plane, but that's another thing I absolutely love about it, is because it has that extra girth to it, that extra weight to it, that really makes it easy to use it. Now, one thing you're going to notice is it has this really huge knob on the front. This is not the standard knob. In fact, the standard knob is way over here, and it's just this little brass one. This particular knob is an accessory that you can buy for the low angle block plane, along with, you can buy like this tote here, which looks an awful lot like a regular hand plane tote, or if you prefer to maybe have a tail ball like this one. What you can do with your low angle block plane is, when you put this knob on the front here, or you don't even have to have the knob, it's sold separately, you can take this tote or the ball to tail, and there's two little screws on the back here that come standard with it, and you can just put this in here, and essentially what you've created is a very small low angle smoothing plane. And of course you can get different blades for the low angle block plane, so you can essentially create a low angle smoother to help you with whatever wood you're working with, especially with highly figured or certain hardwoods. A low angle plane just works fantastic, and with this little setup, essentially you've created what would amount to like a number three or a number two smoother, and it works fantastic. I've used it and I've gotten really great results with it. So that's one of the things I absolutely love about the low angle block plane. Another one, we don't have it in the shop as of right now, but you can get a chamfer guide for the front of this. So you just simply remove the adjustable mouth here on the bottom, which is really, really easy. It's a matter of just taking off the knob and then it will just drop right out of it. Pop that on there and then you can use this as a chamfering plane. Now, two more other hand planes that I want to talk about, miniature ones. Brand new to the shop. In fact, you just saw me use it recently on a build project for Samantha's bookcase. And that is the small scraper plane. Now, this is just, it works great because it fits in the palm of your hand. I have small hands. It fits in there perfectly. So I can get it right exactly where I want to. The blade projects on both sides, so you can get it right up into the corner, right up against an edge if necessary. And then on top of it, the palm handle here, the palm position, you can tighten it and you can turn it into different angles so that, again, you can get the right fit, so you can get right in there nice and tight into any corner if necessary. And the blade is really easy to adjust. It's just a matter of taking a small screwdriver, putting it in the back, and getting that flex into the blade so you can get a very light cut or you can get a heavier cut depending on what it is that you need to take care of. Brand new on the market, and it's fantastic. Another little tool that I really love, and this fits right into my apron pocket, is the small Veritas router plane. This is really great, so perhaps you've maybe cut some grooves and you just need to slightly touch up the bottom, something's not touching, or maybe even with a shallow mortise or something. This works fantastic for that. And I use it all the time whenever I've made dados or grooves and I just want to clean them up a little bit, maybe even to get into a rabbet. This is what I reach for. I absolutely love it. And this makes a fantastic stocking stuffer. Now, since we're kind of talking about some of the planes and everything, a tool that really acts along the line of a plane, in fact, it's along the lines of this scraper plane, is, of course, card scrapers. And card scrapers come in a number of sizes, but one thing for sure is, if I can get this out, card scrapers are just fantastic because they're really easy to use. Basically, all you do is put a nice little burr on it, flex it, and then push it, or you can even pull it depending on how you prefer to do it, and you can get a very smooth, nice finish or surface ready for finish. Now, sometimes with a card scraper, the hardest part is either doing the flexing and keeping it nice and flexed. Your thumbs can get tired, they can start to burn literally because the metal heats up, and that's where an accessory much like this comes in. And that is, of course, the scraper holder. And the neat thing is you just simply get your scraper ready to go, and it's a matter of kind of turning these knobs a little bit, sliding the scraper into position, tighten the knobs, get the scraper in place, and it's going nowhere. And the neat thing about that is, number one, here on the front, it's